With Tre'Davious White out for the season, Dane Jackson is the next man up. So what does he bring to the table? Jackson is a competitive defender against the run and pass. Whether he is at depth or up in the box, he is a willing tackler. Even better than Tre'Davious White. Jackson always comes up with purpose and has an average tackle depth of 3.4 yards, which ties him 11th with rookie Greg Newsome. It's a small sample size, but his run stop percentage is 7.1%, and that's ranked 7th among all corners. That's better than Taron Johnson, Levi Wallace, and Tre'Davious White. Jackson consistently makes sure he's in position to make a sound tackle on running backs, especially when teams run plays that are meant to put the running back one-on-one with a corner. Jackson has saved big plays and touchdowns on these sort of plays over the years. Jackson is at his best when he is in a bail technique or an off coverage, alignments and techniques that allow him to keep his eyes on the QB while reading the route combinations. He does such a good job at reading routes and route concepts from these looks. It allows him to anticipate and squeeze routes at the top of the break, which doesn't force him to be super twitchy, because that is just not his game. Off coverage allows him not to only see the routes developing, but where the overlapping gray areas are in the coverage call, so that he can choke the route and close the passing windows that will open up. Here he plays with great zone eyes, stays over the top of the number one, and is hoping that the QB throws the out route to the tight end so he can pick it off. But he deters a quarterback from making the throw. Last week, many thought this was a double move, but it was just Jackson reading the quarterback hitting the top of the drop. My guess is that he saw Simeon prepare to throw just as the receiver got into his blind spot. Jackson probably expected a stop or comeback route. Was he wrong? For sure. But having that aggressive mentality with the ball spotted to the short side of the field and a safety over the top isn't something that can be coached up. That sort of anticipation is what has put him around the ball his entire college and NFL career. Even on the play where Poyer picked off Simeon, many fans thought Jackson was straight up beaten. And don't get me wrong, he'll need to keep speed receivers in front of him because he doesn't have the recovery speed. But take another look at how he does his job at the line of scrimmage by funneling the receiver inside to help Poyer deep. That extra time and space, along with the receiver trying to stack Jackson, gave Poyer time to get over the top of the route. The throw is a tad inside with the receiver stemming outside. Interception, all-pro Pope. Jackson's ability to defend high to low and space routes are tremendous for such a young player. Here he takes away the deeper route, but look how he continues to backpedal to keep both the routes in his peripheral. Then, when the quarterback is forced to throw to the shallow target, he pounces to make a play on the ball. The Bills aren't going to ask Jackson, or Wallace for that matter, to do what White did. They will call zone and match zone coverages to allow their corners to rarely be out-leveraged. But when the opportunities arise, when they do disguise a coverage or send a pressure, and Jackson is asked to make a play, he needs to take advantage of it. And I fully expect him to. Will there be ups and downs? Absolutely. But he's got to play his game and keep confidence in himself, just like the front office and staff has over the last couple years.